I'm not a conservative or I'm a backstabber. I'm not a Republican. When I've busted my ass for 2 damn years for you, you can go to hell. You can go to hell. I'm not a conservative now, you want to say, but the person who's left his 2 minor children, beats women, holds guns to women, says he's a conservative, I'm not? Excuse me? Funds abortions? You want to say I'm not a conservative because I'm calling out some of the dumbassery that is going on right now? Are you crazy? Is this how you want to live your life for the rest of our lives, supporting these insane candidates? Are you kidding? So because I check my own side, you say I'm a traitor and I'm a liberal? Get off my page immediately. I want you to unfollow me, you psychopath. Get off my page.
Well, Christian Walker, son of Herschel Walker, as you saw there, had some choice words still after his father lost that election to Raphael Warnock yesterday. And many people apparently are coming for him. Traitor. Can't believe you turned on the party. What'd you do? The whole time he was silent about it until some things just boiled over, which I think he addressed, because he went on a Twitter thread as well about many of those things. And I think people finally got to him and then he had to respond. Here's more of what he tweeted. He said, don't beat women, hold guns to people's heads, as he mentioned that in that Twitter space there. Fund abortions, then pretend you're pro-life, stalk cheerleaders, leave your multiple minor children alone to chase more fame. Lie, 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 say stupid crap and make a fool of your family. And then maybe you can win a Senate seat. Long story short, just stop being a deplorable human being and stop trying to hide the absolute truths that are within your life. There's folks who do this type of stuff, but they usually don't think they can just bypass all of it, let it become public, and think other folks will say, yeah, that's my guy. Sadly, a decent percentage of people did say that. Here's more from Christian. He said, don't compare Warnock running over his wife's foot to my father holding guns and knives to my mother's throat, threatening to kill his therapist, her and one of his adulteresses in a therapy session, and telling my mom and I that he was going to beat our asses. Get off my page. There's someone else that wasn't getting off his page. His name is Dinesh D'Souza. You shouldn't have done this though, but Dinesh said this, I like Christian Walker a lot. I had him on my podcast. He's suffered being raised without a dad. Didn't really point out why he suffered being raised without a dad, but still. He said, but his parents divorced in 02 when he was 3. Everything he says about his dad seems largely derived from his mom. An embittered ex-wife is hardly a balanced or reliable source. Who the are you, Dinesh, to talk about someone else's family as if you've been in there and you know what kind of bittered ex-wife she is? Or maybe it was a battered ex-wife. Still, Christian had some words for him. I'm glad he did. He said, you came for every single mother who raised their child while dealing with abuse. My mom protected me, loved me, and cared for me. My opinions of my father are from my experiences, not hers. I messaged you privately and respectfully, and you didn't delete this. How dare you? He continued off by giving his mom a little bit more shine. Here's that last tweet from him. He says, this is my amazing mom who's had her name and image dragged through the media unwillingly. She refused to talk to any journalist after 18 months of stalking. I blew up after she was lied on multiple times. And shout out to every strong mother whose story goes untold. We love you, he says. I don't know if the healing process can begin at this point. I doubt it will, because there's I assume there's people that won't admit to the wrongs that they've done and the ways that they've gone through this whole thing. But there's one more piece of confirmation to what Christian was saying, because it was many more of the things on his Twitter page. One of those about how his Herschel Walker's family begged him not to run, but there was this one guy named Donald Trump who told him to. And then they said, hey, you've got way too much stuff in your past. You've got too much of folks that are surrounding you whose lives will have to be put on blast as well. And he said he did not listen. This is who he listened to. This was a statement on March 10th of last year from Donald Trump. Wouldn't it be fantastic if the legendary Herschel Walker ran for the United States Senate in Georgia? Many people at that point said no, but he still went on. He said he would be unstoppable. Look at the reasons why. And think about Laura Ingraham's pissed and mad lines about the reasons why Donald Trump said he should run. He'd be unstoppable, just like he was when he played for the Georgia Bulldogs and the NFL. He was also a great person. Run, Herschel, run. Yo, this ain't a football commercial. This isn't NFL Fox on Sunday. It's none of that stuff, bro. But he thought it would be enough, because all it takes is fame, right? People like me, right? Apparently not anymore when they found out who you're really about. I know the Walker family's gotten all this attention, and negatively, of course, and we saw a lot of the support that's happening. By the way, don't get it twisted. Christian Walker is not like he's, you know, left the whole thought process of many of these conservatives. He's on the Ron DeSantis train, it seems, but he's just off of Trump and, of course, his father, Jess.
Yeah, Christian Walker and this whole beef, if you will, between him and his dad is just exemplifying how conservatives believe that lifestyle choices are political views and are politics, right? None of these things are policy matters that they're debating over. They're personal choices. Funding abortions for women that he got pregnant, personal choice. Government shouldn't be involved in that. Very simple. Christianity, personal choice. Government shouldn't be involved in that. Doesn't affect the people of Georgia whether or not the person that represents them is a Christian. What policies are they pushing in Congress for you? Sexual orientation, again, personal freedom. The government should not be involved in that. What is the government doing for you? Why do we have a government? These are questions that conservatives don't really ask, and I know this. I used to be a conservative, so I understand this mentality until like the age of like 19 or so. And then I started to learn that actually these beliefs that you have about how you should live your life personally have nothing to do with policy making and government. We all work hard, we all pay taxes. This idea that there shouldn't be welfare and people are living off of the system is something conservatives believe a lot. And we have to, you know, have trickle down economics so that we have a big booming economy. But if you work hard, you're already putting in the effort to get something of value in return, to have public schools be funded, to have Social Security and Medicare so that you can actually have a retirement after working for over 40 hours per week every day of your life. Like, you've done the work, you've put in the literal dollars oftentimes, but sometimes, you know, you've got a corporation that's exploiting your labor, paying you very small wages and profiting a lot. We've seen now the trend and the difference in the amount of money that companies are spending on labor versus their profits. They're paying people such a small amount of money for so much value that they're earning off of their labor. They should be taxed, and that money should be going into pools for things that are public goods. But we've gotten so distracted from what the government is for and what it's supposed to do to be a way to collectivize our resources and use them for things that we need. And so it's really sad to see our political discourse devolve to this, but that's really where we're at. And so now it's just a fight over who is more holy, and Ron DeSanctimonious seems like a great person for someone like Christian Walker who sees politics this way.
And that's the way they've been told, is they're brainwashing. By the way, the question that you asked right there that would maybe break that spell, I wrote it down. What is the government doing for you? UPS had a slogan that said, "What's Brown doing for you?" I think years ago. And that was a slogan that lets people know, hey, we care about your predicament, your plight, what your situation is. If anytime we have elected leaders whose job it is to tell you you're lazy if you want the government that you paid into, there's this weird relationship that they think they've cultivated with folks, which they have, I guess, with their followers, is that you're supposed to be a part of this process where it goes one way and nothing comes back. But we continue to call us the land of opportunity. Where the F does the opportunity come from? Does it come from me working my ass off while you give all this money to the folks at the top to continue to keep me working my ass off where I get nowhere? Where's the opportunity? My children can't go to a decent school. I can't get off work enough to even take them there. Childcare, daycare, anything that comes through these things that cultivate and make a successful opportunity rich environment in this country are not being cultivated. They're not being implemented. For folks that want to, they get called lazy. They get called handouts and wanting to suck off the teat of the America. Hey, we put it in. They continue to lose that. So the first question you ask whenever you want to vote for anyone is, what is it they're going to do for me? How is this country going to get better? And attacking someone because they're transgender or because they're gay or because they're black, or because they're Latino, because they're an immigrant, isn't doing anything for making your life better. That's why you're still complaining, because they want you to.